last time I tried to do this crap, I kept fucking up. I don't got Michelle smart when it comes to this. If it wasn't for Michelle's up, I'd be totally messed up.
I had to help her figure out how to fix the brightness contrast control so that the picture didn't look like crap. Yeah, well, it still looks like crap. So anyway, you can jump ahead to the... So, alright, so, here's the short skinny guys. This is the live stream, this is us, we're here, I don't know how long it takes for Google Hangouts to get it. What are you looking for, Michelle? I'm trying to see where we are.
This is the live stream, this is us, we're here, I don't know how long it takes for
Google Hangouts. You're going to have to move the camera over a little bit.
I'm trying to see.
Okay, I'll take care of that.
Alright,
so... So let's take care of that. We gotta move the camera just a tiny bit because we're a little out of center.
Actually, that should be right anyway.
Yeah, okay. So
let's get started with the most important thing
right now. I'm going to set off camera so you can see this. This is our test card. This is our test card that looks like crap. This test card clearly could do a lot better than it is. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to use this to get our channel up.
Let's get ourselves situated.
We also are backing this up simultaneously on the other computer. So the Intel Core, the Pell version is being released right now, and I think the picture looks pretty good. I think it looks pretty good too. I think we finally began the process of nailing down the problems that we're having with the camera for a while. I'm not saying it's perfect, but it is working. By the way, Michelle busted her back to fix this plug for the time being, and she does have plan to order some switchcraft replacements for this socket, which sucks. It's cheap Chinese garbage. It does not hold up. It's actually starting to show signs of cracking apart right here at the strain relief that's molded on it. So we are going to be replacing the plug. Right. Okay, so let's test the sound system.
Welcome to the messaging service. No messages. Main menu. To send a message, press 2. To work with your greetings, press 3. To change your settings, press 4. Get or deleted messages, press 6. To leave this mailbox and log on as another subscriber, press 7.
Okay, the reason we did that was put the phone over here is so that you can use the same microphone to pick up both phone and me at the same time. Because we have our headphones, so we'll be able to hear the sound. And, of course, we want to be able to hear you. Now, for those of you who are watching this on Google Hangouts on air or on YouTube, unfortunately, we are not going to be able to watch the comments on the screen because Dory's not here. there's no way we can watch the computer from here. So I'm asking you to start by please understanding that I will definitely would love to answer your questions, but because I can only watch the phone right now, although maybe once in a great while I will slip it over there and look. It will not be like I'm going to be able to answer questions on both devices in real time. So this is definitely the first time officially I have scheduled a call-in show. Michelle will be having hers officially on Thursday and Friday of this week using the same technology that we're using right now. Which means, of course, that for some of you people, you're probably going to be seeing yourself as, wow, can't you guys get a better picture than this? It sucks. The answer is no, unfortunately, we can't. This is the only thing we have available at this point. So, you will have to just bear with it, guys, okay? Of course, we do welcome your donations and any assets, any kind of resources or better equipment. Even if it's older equipment that may be sitting in your storage warehouse or whatever, we certainly can use that too. I would think there's a lot of people who always are thinking that we need to buy brand new gear. No, we don't have to buy new gear. We will accept older gear that is at least usable for something. So if you really are interested and donating cameras, phone patches, microphones, lights, your time. Not always can use that. We always use volunteers. Just contact me at lumifinistra@gmail.com. Or, of course, Michelle at bichelle3@gmail.com. And we also accept, of course, cash donations. If you contact Michelle or me, I will give you the information of how to mail us a donation, or if you want to make it through PayPal or through Patreon. The Patreon page is www.patreon.com/bichelle, and PayPal is, you send the payment to bichelle3@gmail.com, and those will help to make this channel a little more better. Michelle had always wanted to get to have interactive backdrops and things like you see on Infowars.com, which obviously she doesn't have the gear for that. So anyway, I'm going to let Michelle join us and see. Michelle, how you doing?
I'm fine.
How's the leg? My leg. actually, it's not doing too bad right now. It was a little tender, but, it seems to be doing better. I was helping Lumi set up the studio here, and, it was not really hurting too bad. So, I was really happy to see that I was able to get these, live streams up. And, do you think that the regulars are going to log in and ask questions? Huh. You know, that's a great question. I don't know. I have nothing against the regulars asking questions. I just ask that they, you know, be respectful and that, you know, we'd like to, you know, be to one to, speak, you know, to say hello to you guys. Right. Now, Michelle had been planning on buying some camera stuff this month, and you obviously had plans to start buying stuff for your darkroom.
Yes, I did.
Okay, are we still going to do that? Yes, we are. We're buying the timer. We're buying the thermometer. Mm-hmm. We could buy a development tank, or we can buy the exposure meter. Which do you think would be the more prudent accessory at this point? I don't know. It's a toss-up because the exposure meter is it would be good to have as a backup, because the one that was lost was my backup. So if the one in my camera ever died, I could always use that to help set the exposure. But of course, you realize that the T-stops and the F-stops on some lenses don't exactly match one-to-one. Yes, that's true. Okay. And T-stops and F-stops are completely different formulas. For most people, they don't really normally think about it. And if you're using through the lens metering anyway, TTL metering, it really doesn't normally matter, because the sensor on your mirror or in your focal plane is going to determine, based on the light it's seeing on the mirror, it's going to determine what the best shutter speed and f-stop is. But if you're using a separate meter and you don't have it calibrated to the actual exposure meter on the lenses, apertures, and t-stops, it can get really ugly. It could get ugly. Okay, but obviously tonight you have been you originally mentioned about the phone, and I think some people may not have understood that about the phone. I wanted to ask you if you would be willing to explain what the situation with the phone is. You mean with the issue of the, yes. Okay. The situation with the phone, I gotta make sure I sit up here, because otherwise I get, you know what the problem is? What? We are too... We have the camera too high. We do? We have it too high. Gotta bring it down a little bit. We'll bring it down a little bit. This is the kind of stuff that we have to do. An adjustment. Let's see. Also, it doesn't help any of the cameras on stage. That it's not... center. No, it is. Okay. Here we go. Here. Any comments? Yeah, there are some. No, wait. No, there isn't. We have two viewers, and so we are in frame. So, I got two viewers online, me and probably other people. Okay. So, it's really exciting to see how this works. Do you understand how this works at all? Ugh. No. Oh, you're not alone. So anyway, we're going to be taking phone calls. Yes. And today we'll be willing to cover a variety of topics, because we are not tied to a lithium-ion battery or lithium-polymer battery in a cell phone. Overheating, potentially going boom, as photo inductor demonstrate just how much damage that can do to your phone. If your battery goes boom. You think there's any way we can play that video? That's a great question. I think we can. Yes, we can. We can play the photo introduction video. Of course, if we do, please understand that he was physically demonstrating what happens if you puncture a battery with something that's metal. Say, for example, you're getting careless and you take it out of your thing. So, that's what he was doing. And, by the way, this YouTube app, I'm going to be switching over here. Let's see. Don't stop the broadcast. I'm not going to stop the broadcast. But I got to find out how you load it. Okay.
YouTube gadget would like to know. Okay, in order to start. Really? Oops. Did you start it? Alright. How does that work? We're back to let in. We are. Yeah. Every Wednesday is the video late. Okay. Hit OK. So now, how do I select the video? Okay. Click add video to playlist to search for videos. How do I do that? Add video to playlist. Oh, okay. I see how. Over here. I'm gonna find photo introduction. Okay. Photo in connection. Okay, so let's see. I'm gonna show you. Okay. Then I want plants. Okay. Put battery. Can I search for shorter ones in this? This is awfully long. Photo induction. Lithium battery. Don't ask me how this thing figures it out. Pokemon? I don't think so. There we go. This is what we're going to show you. So we're going to put this on. I did add video. It's not working. No. Okay. Click on add video. That's not working. Lithium polymer cell. So, okay, so you did add one. I added one. did add video. Maybe you can't add other people's videos. Okay, maybe I can't. Oh, this sucks. This sucks. Okay, we're going to be coming back into the studio right now because we couldn't get the stupid damn thing to work. Okay. What photo induction demonstrated, which we can't play you, is what happens when a battery gets punctured. Sometimes, like, you see Big Clive and he's taking things apart, and there's usually a lithium battery inside. And, it's, well, the package is, it's the baggie, if you will. Looks something like an MRE. Yeah, meal's ready to eat. Or more like meal ready to explode. Yeah, it does do that. So the I'm a little bit disappointed we couldn't get it to work. Don't worry about it, Michelle. We'll get it working. I promise you, we'll get it working. All right, now, what is the story with... Back to One Watcher. Of course. All right, well, let's spice up things here. Give us a call. We'll talk about almost... Well, anything within reason. 860-738-8463. Again, that's 860-738-8463. So, give us a call, and we will share our thoughts with you, and maybe we can both learn something new from each other. If we don't get any calls today, we will, of course, be covering a video next week on Monday as well. Michelle, of course, will be doing her video on Thursday and Friday. And Dory Myville may also be getting involved with the live streaming as well. But at this point, she doesn't know what kind of materials we should cover. Yeah, exactly. I don't know what kind of materials I'd cover either. But, well, first thing I noticed, for those of you who do not know, if you look at the screen, you can see our background of our wallpaper. Yes. But it seems to me like the Google Hangouts is doing something with the peach walls and they're not allowing the pink peach walls to go through to the camera. Yeah, that is weird. It's definitely doing that. It's not allowing the wall to pass the true color. By the way, it was obvious. For those of you who do want to know about current events and news, this has been reporting on Fox News. We're going to load this up real quick here. Ah, we got a phone call. That's nice. Let's get that. Go ahead, call me on the air. Hold on a minute. Let me turn the sound up here. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
How's it going?
Good, good. How about yourself?
Excuse me?
How are you doing?
I'm doing fine. You got two people here. I'm Lumi and Finster, and of course, you know Michelle. I think more people than me. You're right. So, how can I help you? So, what are you thinking about today?
Well, I used to be a Jehovah's Witness. I just go around telling people that they hurt little children.
Excuse me? I don't have the greatest hearing in the world. I'm trying to adjust the volume here. So, could you ask that again?
Oh, I put you on speaker. I couldn't. I don't know if you can hear me better now.
Yeah. Well, I don't know how long the program's going to actually run for because there's been somebody do a call right now. This is my first live stream. Michelle has been doing them more than me.
Of course, Michelle will
anyway,
be...
Anyway, you can put the Hangouts link so I could join you.
Excuse me?
Oh, right there in the chat. Can you put, like, a Hangouts link? Or you're not streaming with Hangouts?
Well, you know, here's the problem. We'd love to chat, but the problem is right now, we are, unfortunately, don't have anybody else to help man the camera and then man the live chat. So the Google chat, in this case, is only being used because the other means of live streaming didn't work out for us. So the easiest way to chat is to do what you're doing right now, is just to talk on the phone, and we'll try to answer your question within reason. So, because maybe when Michelle's girlfriend comes over on Thursday, there'll be two people, there'll be her asking Michelle the questions, and of course Michelle will ask questions, and I'll answer questions too. But for right now, it's just us, and there's no one else here to help us. So, if you have a question you'd like to ask.
Oh, yeah, I was just wondering what the spiritual growth, what does that mean?
Excuse me?
Oh, I said in the description, spiritual growth.
Well, my channel on here on YouTube has more, you discuss normally things like spirituality and faith systems. Michelle's channel tends to cover the general everything. Yeah, I cover news, weather, things like that. Yeah. So it gets kind of, but today is a multidiscipline chat, meaning we're going to be having a variety of different topics that we'll be covering tonight.
Oh, I thought you were going to give me advice on my mind, body, and soul.
Well, we have a live audience right now. That's just it. But because of the fact is that we don't have anyone right now to... Because we can't see the screen and the keyboard from where we're sitting. Because the way the camera's set up right now, it's only in this one room. So that is the computer's in another room completely separate from this room. And if you may remember, if you cut us a little earlier, we went into the other room to try to put on a video from photo induction about lithium polymer battery explosions, which we couldn't play because it wouldn't let us play it. Probably because we didn't own the video. Right, so that's when we were off camera, and you probably...
Right. They'll shut your live stream down if you play any music or something.
By the way, how does the picture look for you? I mean, how does the picture look? Does the picture look okay?
No, I don't know what picture you're talking about.
The picture in the live stream.
The live stream? Oh, yeah, it looks fine.
Okay, that's good. I'm glad to hear that.
Right. I don't know, maybe it's my computer.
Well, you know, what it is the biggest problem with the picture is that we're using a whole bunch of cheap Chinese shit to make it work, and that's where you saw a loss of quality. The UVC, the composite, the UVC dongle, which uses the generic app, video class driver, as Michelle explained, just doesn't allow, the driver on the Mac does not give us the kind of fine tune to set the exposure right, so it looks like crap. But we will probably be uploading, if the picture looks like we need to, the live, the SD PAL copy of the video, which is being recorded on another computer in another room. Yeah, so because we're maintaining our own backup video feed so that we can actually, in case something goes wrong with the live stream, at least we can still give the audience something to watch. Right.
Yeah, you always have to, you have to entertain the people.
Excuse me?
Oh, it's good to entertain the people.
Well, I don't know what you mean by entertain. Because normally my channel is more of current events and news. Right. And my channels usually cover spirituality and faith discussions. So, I mean, as far as entertain, you mean like play musical instruments, sing, blow shit up? Yeah, well, that's not Michelle and me. We don't blow shit up. In fact, we have to keep what little shit we got. Very true. So, where are you calling from anyway?
I'm calling from California.
Okay. And how's the weather right now in California?
Not too hot, not too cold.
Well, right now here in this area, it's about... Where's Michelle? Is she? It's what, 18, 19 degrees Celsius outside? Yeah, it's pretty mild out there. It's not bad at all.
It's like Fahrenheit. It's like 80 degrees Fahrenheit over here.
What's that?
We call it Fahrenheit.
Oh. Well, right now, I mean, where we are, the sun is shining. People are going outside. They're doing outdoor activities. So, what's the temperature right now in California?
Well, it's 80 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay, so it's like, what, about 20... It's about 23 degrees Celsius, I think. Is it? Yeah. No, wait, it's a little higher than that. But not much, but okay. Yeah, I think it's a little higher than that. I think it's like... Oh, shit. I have to convert between Fahrenheit and Celsius. I hate that. Okay. Well, okay. I know what 80 degrees Fahrenheit feels like. Trust me. Because once it gets to that temperature, it's when I have to stay inside. Otherwise, I get sick. So which part of California are you from anyway?
Palm Springs. The resort town.
Oh, you're in Northern California.
Oh, no, Southern.
Oh, you're Southern California, so you're not too far away from possibly, like, Los Angeles.
No, that's 2 hours away.
Okay. Because I know California is a big, big state. Well, maybe we can ask you a question about something that we have heard about, that California had thought about seceding from the Union because the fact that Donald Trump had won. Did that ever go through the state general legislature to cede from the United States and become its own country?
No, I've never heard of that before.
Oh. It's the kind of stuff Michelle... It's the kind of stuff Michelle covers. Trust me. She always is talking about stuff like that and researching news and views and information that some people just can't use. Sorry, Chris.
Yeah, well, Donald's been over here in my hometown all the time.
What's that?
Donald Trump used to own a casino over here.
Well, I think right now Donald Trump is doing a pretty doggone good job. He's...
I heard what he forgot to sign some sort of executive orders.
What's that?
He forgot to sign some executive orders.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I look at what's going on right now is that he's already canceled TPP. He's already said he wants to renegotiate NAFTA. Through his efforts, a lot of companies are beginning to make a decision to return to the United States. More people are going back to work. Less undocumented illegal aliens are coming across the border. He's taking bids to build that wall. And he and Ryan are going to come ahead again, and they're going to work on repealing Obamacare for a second time. And hopefully this time it'll work. And this time I think it will, yeah.
From what I've seen. Will be elected for 8 years or just four?
Excuse me?
You think he'll, people will vote for him again 4 years from now?
Well, I mean, the way I see it is right now is, I think this country right now, if we can start bringing jobs back into this country, we can start putting more people back to work and get people off the entitlement programs that do have the ability to do some work. And, not only that, can we make a fucking better plug than this piece of... Ever seen these cheap Chinese plugs? They're terrible. Michelle had the
dick. Oh, I heard his stuff is good.
Michelle had to dick with this thing all day long just to get this thing to work. Because the stupid spring contacts were not made out of material that properly made connections. It's almost like they weren't even... It was like they didn't have any phosphor bronze in the springs, and the plug just kept working loose all the time. So, yeah. Well, anyway, one of the things is I want to thank you very much for being part of the show and things like that. And I know that Lumi and I are going to try to do the good job that we can. And, of course, you'll be hearing more from me on my show on Thursday and Friday of this week coming up at the same time at 5 p.m. Eastern Time. And so would you like to ask anything else before we ring off so we can give room for the next caller?
No. Thank you for your time.
Okay. Thank you for calling. Bye-bye. That was the first legitimate caller we ever had. Really. No, it's not the first. It's the first I had. Okay, I'll give you that. All right, so first call I had, that was legitimate. Thank you very much, your legitimate caller. I really thank you very much for being a part of this groundbreaking effort by me and Michelle. This is officially the, officially this is my second video on live stream through Google Hangouts on air. Right. Okay, so, but like we said, please understand for all those of you who are watching this on Google Hangouts on air or through YouTube, we cannot watch both the computer and the phone at the same time. Dory, next on Thursday and Friday of this week, will be here. And Dory can read the questions to us. And we can answer the questions with Dory, and Dory can type our responses. Because we can't watch you guys on the chat and at the same time try to look like we're focusing on you, the caller, on the eye-to-eye contact. Or more like eye-to-lens contact. Right, because unfortunately when you're legally blind, there's absolutely very little you can do to keep a sense of people feeling like that you're ignoring them. And one of the hardest things to do, it's bad enough when Michelle has to use her iPhone to, what are you going to do? I just want to see how we're doing. I rest my case. Oh, yes, Michelle was going to watch. Okay, non-evasion moves forward. Okay, so Gorsuch nomination moves forward. And the unmasked Susan Rice, named as Intel boss to expose Team Trump surveillance. Ready to go, nuclear. Gorsuch wins Senate judicial panel approval. Todd Stern says, school board says nanny still can't go to prom. Why? Because usually prom is usually for teenagers. Yeah, well, if you don't have any friends, I guess there's no reason why they can't make exceptions. Revival roadblocks. Rebuilding hard-hit coal country starts with roads. Let's see what else we got. Claims of Russian swing state meddling, red herring, says election experts. Gun rights activists on a political roll with four recent wins. There's a sponsored piece of news. And your nightly snoring nightmare with this simple tip. That's clickbait. Kidnapped California girl jumps from moving car after sexual assault, police say. Patrick Ewing hired as Georgetown men's basketball coach. More mom of three dies after finding finishing Pennsylvania half marathon. Some tied networks, foundations joined forces to create Trump Resistance Fund. Give me a break. Yeah, I can disagree with it. Kansas dad admits he killed some and fed to pigs. Why? That must have been a pretty rotten kid. I must have been like, why would he do that? I had no idea. Southeast Storm's fifth person reported dead as severe weather moves east. Texas man charged after firing indiscriminately at two men attacking his fiance. Bed Bath and Beyond. The truth. Retailer says Ivanka Trump line still available. Bill Weather XC It. How Trump can win the summit with China this week. St. Petersburg subway blast. Two suspects believed to be to have planted bombs. 11 dead. Trump will allow immigrants to obtain citizenship through military service. Well, it makes sense. Of course. You fought, you served. It just shows that you're willing to be an American citizen. And in fact, I've seen that was usually done sometimes in World War II as well. A lot of immigrants came over in World War II and fought for this country as well. Robin Shahini released from Iran prison, but his freedom isn't guaranteed. North Korea leader Kim Jong-un desperate, ready to strike U.S., defector says. NYPD reportedly defiled sanctuary city status after allowing ICE on illegal immigrants court dates. Muslim American leader supports Australian imams rejection of radical Islam. And last one, Stella Daisy ship missing. Chemical change in cargo may have doomed freighter. What? I have no idea what that's all about. That's just the news for the, let's go to the news for Infowars.com. Yeah, this is, Infowars.com is the channel we use a lot of news of, and, so we tend to do things like that. So this is from Infowars.com articles. Yes, let's allow the Syrian people to decide for themselves. Live, Obama advisor caught spying on Trump. Somalian asylum seeker rapes two elderly disabled men in a care home before murdering one of the victims' wives in Germany. Ouch. Islamists co-opt BLM to shut down activist Hirsi Ali. Tommy Robinson attacked by Antifa at Britain First Rally. Susan Rice flashback. I know nothing about Trump unmasking. Yes. I know those kind of people. It's almost like something that Colonel Schultz would say. I know nothing. I don't want to know nothing. But yeah, but you're the one who just said you did it, dummy. Well, I take the fifth. I say I know nothing. CNN interviews fake police chief. Legislation introduced to save Americans with no insurance on exchanges from tax penalties. Yeah, because we need to talk about that. Tesla production deliveries had a recent quarter ahead of Model 3 launch. And I'm just going to go a few more through here. Android overtakes Windows as world's most used operating system. Right, and that's not too surprising. Right, and we'll talk about why. This is more of your stuff anyway. We have a lot of people who use a lot of tablets and phones and things like that. And a lot of them are running either Android, which is the most common, the most powerful. And the mobile sphere of influence. But Android is also starting to show up on embedded devices for home use, including things like Kodi boxes. Yes, Kodi boxes are actually usually running Android or Linux. Like, I have one that runs Raspbian Linux. It's the Raspberry Pi. Absolutely. And it's, I got itch. Ow. She's got an itch in the small of her back. Okay. So it's no surprise, because more and more people are going to embedded devices, such as I said, Android TV boxes to tablets and, of course, cell phones, like Android phone. This is an iOS, iPhone 4S, but still, more and more people are using these type of devices to do everyday work. Emails, texting, Snapchats, photos, things that you don't need a full-size computer for. And the only people who really use a full-size computer are, for the most part, people who are doing some really heavy-duty things like video editing, heavy word processing. Of course, they're using Windows in call centers or corporations. But everyday users are using Android and iOS devices to communicate with the internet. So Windows is clearly going the way of a dinosaur. I think someone just rang their doorbell. One moment! So we're going to leave the door open, which is fine anyway, in case Dory makes it. She could show up. She could. So anyway, here's the deal. So because of the fact that we're using all these mobile technology, and my dress is kind of a bit of a mess here, it's easier to... Somebody coming up the stairs. Somebody is carrying a lot of stuff, it sounds like. Dory, is that you? No, it's not. There's another family moving in next door. In the apartment 7. And that may be very well be them. It might be very well be them. But then one of the... you know, like I said... Alright, so now let's get back to the other things, Michelle. What do you really want to do? What do you really want to buy?
What do I really want to buy?
Yeah, seriously.
What do I really want to buy? Ooh,
okay. This week, I mean, if... I wanted to buy the Seamate, but you do realize if you buy the... Hi, cat.
Yeah, good old Rusty. Come on up, Mr. Cat. Ooh, he's a big cat. Yes, he is.
Hi, guys. This is my kitty. This is Rusty. And he wants to eat.
I can't win.
You can't win. Right back, guys. We'll talk to you while we're feeding the cat. Our microphone's very sensitive.
Yes, it is.
status on the other channel. Here, we have one viewer. I gotta admit, I hope Mr. Viewer is enjoying himself or herself. And
we'll see. We'll find out. All right. So let's get back to my question. What would you really rather buy? If you got almost everything you need for developing the film. Almost everything you need. Except for the developing tank and reel. Which you can get for $30 a Peterson System 4 system. Yes. Okay. So, now here's the question. If you're going to get the tank and reel for $30 this month, okay, and you already got the timer, you're going to order the timer, you're going to order the other stuff, then you're pretty much all set to develop your first film. And the first time in over 13 years. Yes. There's two things that may be a showstopper. Here's number one. Number one, we do not know how we would actually print that said film because we don't have an enlarger or a film scanner. So, you know, if I can develop the negatives and have them all ready to go, there's no guarantee that we'll actually be able to print them right away. Or what happens if, after we take our pictures, we find out that because of the situation with the exposure meter, that the system is not giving consistent results. You mean like the picture is like, okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah, in other words, you're saying is you can shoot all the film you want, but if for some reason your camera's exposure meter is out of whack or the battery's, then would you want to have a backup to compare meter readings with your built-in camera with the external exposure meter? Right. Okay. And then maybe next month we could probably go ahead and get the other stuff. All right. Well, I guess in that case, it makes sense. Now, by the way, one of the things I'd like to wonder is that since we talk about multiple disciplines, how do you feel about those people who are re-exploring older technology like film developing? I think that what happened was, and I think you'll agree again this, that after all those years of digital this, digital that, that some people have begun to wonder if that raw ones and zeros may be limiting the creativity. I mean, I know some people say, well, you know, I can take a picture and I can use Photoshop and I can do all kinds of awesome effects on it. That's still true. You can still do that with film prints, too. I mean, you can still scan in a print or a slide or a negative in to the computer. And again, you could use Photoshop on that film exposure and do things like brighten it, darken it, add special effects to it. Right. And also the other thing is, like one guy said, is that film photography is becoming popular because you can get the equipment relatively inexpensive. And because the other thing is problem with the digital stuff is that you need a computer to, as Abe would call it, to process the videos in the first place. So it's not like you go ahead, you can take a picture, you can send it to a photo lab like color here and get the pictures back. Yes, this company is still in business. Yes, they are. Color Labs are still in business. And here's the newest mailers for C41 Brasses of Film. And yes, they do process C41 only. They don't do slides and they don't do black and white. But we can send our film to the darkroom and they process black and white and slides. It's a bit more expensive. I think I paid like $7.65 for Express to get this film, my one roll film, back to me. Do you think it would be cheaper in the long run to send like 3 or 4 rolls of film at a time to a lab? Yes, I do. I think it would be a lot cheaper and a lot more feasible to send 3 or 4 rolls of film in at a single level. Now, of course, you're not into the CD stuff. No. Unfortunately, I'd love to show you guys these pictures, but I have to be honest when I tell you this. It's kind of sad that the technology that I shot was a chromogenic film called BW400CN that was 7 years old. So because it was 7 years old, I seriously wondered if my exposure meter or my camera may have been out of whack. But may not have been. So let me show you. So these pictures are pretty good. Here's Dory. I know she doesn't look too exciting, but that's Dory. That's what she does. I kind of like that picture. But I think that the one thing about the picture is that worries me is that when I was shot, she was a lot. Well, she's still heavy. Yeah. This is Rusty the cat. You saw Rusty. And, again, this is on a chromogenic black line film called BW400CN. And this is, I like the way this came out. Yeah, his face is the main topic, obviously. Yes, his face is the main topic. And you can see that the rest of his fur is blurry. We're focused on his face. And his side fur didn't really matter as much. Of course, some of these pictures, I admit, didn't come out quite as good as I'd like. There's Frame the cat, my other cat. And I see we have some picture numbers. Yeah, by the way, there's numbers in the back of this. That's right, there's numbers in the back of this. And then I need to explain what this is, okay? This paper here is not... This is actually printed by an inkjet. In other words, what they did was they scanned these in to a printer, and the printer prints the picture. So it's not like, an old style enlargement using an enlarger in the traditional sense. No. That's one thing I miss a lot from working in a darkroom. I'm just going to show you a few pictures real quick here. This shot I like too. It's got a combination of multiple filters on top of it. You got a polarizer, you got a yellow filter, and you got a deep red filter. And it really looks like a silhouette. You can see the tree and the clouds. And it's really, really cool. I like that one a lot because I think it's just kind of really awesome. This is Fame the cat. Crawled up on my bed. This could have been a good picture of Fluffy, Rusty, but unfortunately, it was out of focus, so it's okay, sick. This is our test card. And you'll see that in our test card, you can't see it here in the shot, but you can clearly see how the nature of their system, how they scan the images into the computer, how the image looks. Here's a happy picture of Dory. Here's a happy picture of Dory. She's lying on the bed, playing with her laptop. Yep. And this is another shot of Dory. Yes, indeed. And then, of course, we get more pictures, but I'm going to just try to pick out the best ones from the bunch. Just trying to pick out the ones I think are really cool. This is from Winter Storm Stella. And you can see how the snow was really kind of piling up really fast that day. And really, really kind of cool. It was just a lot of snow. And of course, another picture story. This is our backyard. Ah, here we go. The studio where we are sitting right now. This shows you, you can see the one studio light on. You can see the ceiling fixtures. They're not on right now, but they're there. Just the reels in the wall. You can see over here in the edge, Dory and a friend of mine were sitting on the couch. We're sitting right now. And that's what we do with things. By the way, one thing about Clark Labs I like. Clark Labs is they do this. They return your negatives. Okay. One of the sometimes biggest bullshit stories you hear is company saying it's too expensive to return negatives. Nope. They're not. If you're going to return prints, there's no reason why you can't return negatives. Right. The only thing is you'll see that the negatives here are actually cuts and strips of four. So, if I was to use print file pages on these, might be a little bit harder to do. So, yes, folks. Initially, we will be sending our films out to for the finishing to be processed. Possible labs include Dwayne's photo for the Black Line Pictures and the Dark Room. So absolutely great opportunity. All right, let's take some more calls, Michelle. Okay, sure. 860-738-8463. Again, that's 860-738-8463. Please call now while the rates are low. It's cheap. It's free. You can even call us on Google Voice or Google Hangouts, right? You can, if you have yourself for that. It's a free call using Google Hangouts. Just go to the telephone icon, and once you've configured it, you can call us right from that. 860-738-8463. And if we don't get any calls tonight, me and Lumi will probably be getting ready to wrap it up shortly. So I'd like to take one or two more calls before we leave the audience. And if we don't, for some reason, get you on the call, let you know that you guys can, of course, contact Michelle on her show on Thursday and Friday of this week as well. So, we'll leave the phones open for another sleep bit. And, thanks. All right, so we got the one caller, and I hope that one caller, whoever you may be, will be willing to share these videos with your friends and let them know about our channels, both of our channels, Michelle Marie Delaney's channel, which is the North American Snuffing, and of course my channel, which is Lumi and Finistra here on YouTube. And since we are, obviously, we are multidisciplined, do you want to ask any questions?
Yeah.
Okay. More or less just to kind of help maybe inspire audience to call in and discuss topics. But do you believe that, do you, boy, this is hard. Because I know the answer, but I'm trying to kind of encourage people to call. Do you believe that as we enter Easter, that believing in Jesus Christ is the only way of salvation? It's not. However, it's the easiest one. Because Jesus makes it a lot easier for you if you truly believe that he's your friend, your savior, and that he died on Calvary for your sins by your faith of what he's done through his of his efforts and through your love of him as the messenger, as the Christ. You are guaranteed a VIP pass in to the other side. If you are a person who maybe don't know what to expect, Mother and Father God love you unconditionally, no matter what. You don't have to do anything funky to get Mother and Father God to be there for you. Because Mother and Father God love you from day one. Mother and Father God are there to help you be the best you can be. Right. And that's something very important to remember. Mother and Father God are always there for you. Will always be there. So if you ever feel that you are not worthy to receive the kingdom of God, let me wake you up to one piece of reality. Jesus is your friend, your confidant, and he loves you unconditionally, as does Father Yahweh and Mother Asna. And even if you don't think you're worth loving, every single person, even the bad ones, are special into the eyes of Mother and Father God. And they will always be there for you if you ask for their help. No matter what. You can be the most horrible person in the world. You can be, beyond disgusting. It doesn't matter. Mother and Father God will always be there for you because they love you. And they love you unconditionally. There is no conditional love. It's unconditional. They love you, screw ups or not, they will be with you 100%. But you got to ask for them to help you out and be with you in your life. You have to be willing to open the door. They're not going to push it open and try to force their way into your life. Okay, so, and how do you do that? You just pray. You pray and ask them to be with you. And no matter what happens, they always will be there listening. Okay, what about the Mother Asna's forces, the throne, the principalities and mothers, workers, her jobs, their job is to act as the defenders. And the same thing with Father Yahweh's thrones. They're there to serve and protect you from evil. The most well-known of Father Yahweh's thrones is the Archangel Michael. which we often say in Catholic Mass, Saint Michael, defend us in battles, keep us free from the snares of the devil. Right, and that's the most important thing, but he's not the only one. No, he's the archangel, but he's technically, it certainly is the one of the many people who will help lead and organize the forces of good to protect you from evil. Right. Okay, thanks. The next question that I'd like to ask is there anybody in the world that truly feels that no matter whatever you've done, that you are in, you're so corrupt that you cannot enter the kingdom of God? This is more of the statement to the audience. Okay. First thing is I want you to know that Mother God, Father God loves you 100%, and you don't have to be perfect. They will be with you every day of your life. They'll speak up for you. They'll vouchsafe for you. The only thing you have to do is keep your faith. Even if it's a faith, remember what Jesus said to his disciples. Oh, yay, a little faith. Where you had a faith the size of a mustard seed, you could tell that mountain to move and it would move. He also mentions that the little children of the world, you have to be like a child to often receive the kingdom of God. What that means, and I think you agree with me on this, is that which means is when you're a little child, okay, you believe in things that sometimes you cannot understand. You believe certain things can happen by magic. And when you get to be adults, most people stop believing magic in any form, except maybe ear wax. Yeah, well, at least it's not from me. His cat has got the worst earwax problem in his ear. I know. What I mean is, let's finish on getting it. Okay. When you get to grow older, you begin to start becoming skeptical. It's like, almost like you don't believe, can't believe because you have no proof. Ask a child, a truly innocent child, say a kindergartner or maybe even someone like 3 or 4 years old. A lot of them believe in things can be a certain way because they wish it to be. So, does that make them wrong? Of course not. It just means that they believe in the heart of hearts that whatever the case is the case. Like, for example, they might believe that they'll see mom, you know, the mom, the grandmother or grandparents that passed away, or that they're going to, because they were a good boy or girl, that they're going to get something special from Santa Claus this year. Now, I know as adults we tend to go is, Santa Claus ain't real. Easter Bunny ain't real. Christ ain't real. Jesus ain't real. Yahweh ain't real. Ghost ain't real. Well, excuse me, but I happen to believe in the principle of Santa Claus. I happen to believe in the concept of the Easter Bunny. I don't believe in the Easter Bunny as a rabbit hopping around, putting eggs in people's baskets and things like that. I don't believe in Linus's Great Pumpkin, but here's the thing I do believe in. Come on, cat. I believe that every single thing in this world has a reason it exists. And that there is a true means of great things happening. Michelle can demonstrate things to you that you cannot do. Most people can't do. because of her abilities. That's the North American Snow Queen. Right. She can cool food. And not just by blowing on it. Right. And not just by blowing on it. So they can also lower temperatures of room, too, without... Even if it's not a huge amount, you will feel it. You will feel it. The point here I'm going to get at, because I think Lumi would agree with me on this, is the fact this is getting long, is what makes a little child, amazing, is they don't need to have proof to believe. They do believe. And they don't even have to be told. They don't have to be shown evidence. For them, it's... Yeah. No, hey, you explain what it is, and they say, hey, that makes sense. That makes sense. Or they observe, like, for example, when they do the prayers at night, they sleep better. Why is that? I don't know. I do my prayers every night, I sleep better too. But when I was a child, doing my prayers before I went to bed was important because it made it easier for me to sleep because I was giving my issues to Mother and Father God, to Jesus, to deal with so I could get a good night's sleep. And I could be bright-eyed, bushy-tailed in the morning. That is why I did that. And that worked. It worked. It worked 100%. Every day.
All right, that's pretty cool, isn't it? You bet. And, Eversource Smart Prep. What the heck is that? I'm just looking at the phone here. The electric company's up to something. Don't miss your chance to earn up to a $75 incentive. What, how worse? If you already have an eligible smart... Oh, okay. To eligible
I have to admit I would be kind of interesting because that's talking about smart thermostats. Yeah, that's something that's more on my channel. We'll probably discuss that in a couple days on Thursday, but for now I hope that the callers from California will call on my program on Thursday. Same time. It'll be at 5 p.m. Eastern Time. And I hope to hear from Darlene again. I hope to hear from Jennifer again. There were a few people that I did want to hear more from. And I hope that you guys will call my show. And I hope that next week more people will be part of my program as well. And unfortunately, my program right now is only one day a week. Michelle's is 2 days a week. But maybe on Friday, since it's usually pretty quiet Friday, we will try to cover more stuff for both channels on Friday. Right. And don't forget, after we remember this. Oh, hold on, I got a call. Go ahead. Go ahead, caller. Yeah, how are you doing?
Hello, this is Sam. How are you?
I'm doing fine.
But the Volunteer Firefighter Alliance is having its national fundraising drive to help underfunded desperately needed.
You're getting calls like that? Oh, yes. Oh, God. It's like, I love it, don't you? Ah! Whoa, the phone rang. Yes, it did. So somebody was trying to have a fundraiser drive. It's one of those robocallers. We see them a lot. Yes, we do.
And they come and they call it off them. Wonder why they do. I don't know. Okay, guys. If you ever get calls like that, if you ever wondered why those people call you all the time, who knows? They just do. They just do. Right? It's like, why do they call all the time? Who knows? It's a great question. It is a great question. Anyway, the most important thing is I want to thank you all for watching this stream. And, we noticed that our phone is doing something weird. Nah, it's not weird. We've seen this before. What it is that the phone is saying is it can't play our live stream. It doesn't make any sense. Well, maybe, who knows why it does that. But, anyway. So, for the one caller, I want to thank you very much for calling. And for the other callers who or would like to have called but didn't get a chance, you'll get a chance next Tuesday, next Monday. I will be here. And Michelle will be, of course, doing her show on Thursday and Friday of this week. And Dory Myville will probably be doing her show on, one day a week. We don't know what she's going to do or when she's going to do it. But we'll certainly will find out as soon as we can. And we thank you all very much for being part of this show. So for now, guys, we're going to let you go. So don't forget. See you next week. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, guys.